Welcome back to, let's see, this is episode 3 of the Cowling Chronicles. I'm much better off than I was if you go back and look at number 1 and number 2, because I have figured out, at least to my own satisfaction, a process for doing that, and I've finally been able to decipher the instructions now that I've played around a little bit. I've made a few mistakes, but one of the good things, of course, is I can put fiberglass back where it was. I'm still a long way to go. I'm still kind of kicking myself that I didn't do this earlier in the summer when I had some heat, because it was 39 degrees this morning and I'm running out of time to do any fiberglassing and filling. This is an unheated T-hanger, but I'll plug along just as best as I can. Let me show you what I've been doing. And first, let's get the bottom cowling on here so I can show it to you better. So what order should all of this go in? Because the instructions really aren't that clear. The order that I went in, I told some other people about it, and they all went in different orders, not only than I did, but also than other people have. But here's what I've learned so far. Top piece first. Get it, take care of this gap here, this 1/4 inch gap. I use the magazine method. There's like 4 Vans accessory catalogs under there holding it in place. Get your gap squared away here. Have the hinge go. Cut this front off here so that it can fit together. Clean up this so that these can fit more or less together. This is my next big project. There'll be a lot of work on this connection here, and flip that off. Set the bottom cowling, and you really want to do your bottom first, in my case, so that you can bring it all up to fit. Once that's done, you can do the sides. And also, you know, you want to take your a long piece of sandpaper in whatever fashion you're going to use and get this top piece level. I did not trim it to anything yet. So, and then do the hinges on the bottom, and then do your side cut, and then add your hinges here. One of the problems I've got is that I don't have enough hinge material now, so I think I've got to make an order to Vans before I can do anything else. One of the things I've been doing as I've been fitting this thing is I've been adding fiberglass back, which everybody says is the great thing about working with fiberglass, and of course they're right. After I got the gap all nice and fine, I wasn't completely happy with the way it fit on the top cowling and the back, so I added just a sliver, maybe a 1/16 of fiberglass. I had put some 020 aluminum here and then filled it in with the epoxy, and I think that'll close up the gap fine. I did the same with the bottom part too. In fact, there was an RV7A over here parked yesterday, and of course I got underneath it and looked at it while it was parked, and there was a pretty good size gap on the bottom. I've filled mine in so that there isn't that gap. So, and here you can see what I'm talking about with that gap. I had a pretty big honking gap here, probably not too much bigger than I see in a lot of other RVs, but big enough that it bothered me a little bit. And you can see, you can barely see the little part I've put on here. What I did was I fitted this back on, there was a gap here, and then I put a 020 shim here and duct taped it down to mark the border, and then I just went in the other side, filled it in. He's got that dialed up, doesn't he? And you can see the rest of the gap here. And obviously I've drilled all the hinges since the last time we met too. I went with the backlight method, which was I drilled the hinges and put them on first, and then I put a light in the back here and then drilled into the holes. It was a lot easier that way. I also increased the size of the shim here to about, I think it was an 032 I used, because I had reinforced the backside here with a little bit extra fiberglass, and I didn't want it to sit up too high. One of the reasons I kept this gap really short here, why I put this back, is because of course this is where it's going to mate with the bottom, and any difference is going to stick out like a sore cowling. This is the left side. I had a really big gap here. Now you can see it's closed up considerably, and then there's a little bit bigger gap here. I'm okay with this, I think. One of the things I noticed yesterday when I was looking at this RV7A that was on the ramp, he used cam locks, you know, instead of hinges, and I didn't like the look at all. It was all puckered.
I didn't like that at all. I also noticed that down here on the on his nice paint job, he had a lot of dings and dents and chips, I presume from taking the cowling on and off. And so it didn't do much for me. So I'm pretty happy with the whole hinge thing, although when it comes time to drill to the plexi here, I'm not exactly, or to the fiberglass here, not exactly sure how I'm going to do that because there's not much access. So this is a piece that I just trimmed. This is the pilot side, and this is the piece that I just put back on. I just trimmed this, and you can see it fits very tightly in there. I'm going to have to open up that gap, obviously, but the point is that there is no gap here at the moment, and it just fits beautifully. You may remember in one of the other shows I talked about this indentation that appears on the bottom and how it ran down to the side here. I was concerned about that. Once I brought the whole thing up and trimmed the side, there's your bottom of the indentation, and it's exactly where it should be. And I'm very happy about that as well. One of the things I did whenever I cut off the cowling is I save every piece. This is the piece that gets cut to make room for the nose gear. This is the bottom. And I catalog everything, so this is the right side. And if I cut it a second time, I indicate that this is the, let's see, the second cut on the back side. I actually had put some back and cut it again. This is a piece around the corner of the front. Extra piece on the nose gear. Anyway, because you can put fiberglass back, I saved all these pieces so that I could then just kind of duct tape it back, put some epoxy in, put some cloth over it, and cut it again if I wasn't happy with it. And I'm glad I did that, because that worked out pretty well. And this is what I mean when I say this is how it worked for me. I put this back a couple of times after I cut it and drilled it to the hinge. This is the bottom. You're looking at the left bottom here. I can't get under here with you because I get vertigo when I get flat on my back. Anyway, you can see there's almost no gap, a little bit of a gap here, and there's no gap here, slight gap here. And that is from putting that fiberglass back and cutting it again if I wasn't happy with the gap. I did this after I had already drilled the hinge. I looked at a couple of planes, and they have pretty large gaps here because this is underneath. I'll probably open this one up a little bit for a paint gap, but I'm very happy, actually, with how this went. And this is the left side now. As you can see, I've got a line where the edge is, and so today's mission is to slice this and also put the hinge in. And that, once I get that secured and on the other side secured, then the whole cowling is secured to the fuselage, and we can screw around with this stuff up here at the top. And so, first thing I do is catalog it, right? Side, bottom, cowl, and that's cut number one. Anyway, as long as I'm here, let me show you something that drives me crazy. This guy is going out. See how he has that thing angled? This is not the way you start your plane or the angle you have it, facing right into an open hangar. I've talked to this guy about 10 times, and jackass keeps doing it. Anyway, it's nicely here. Maybe a little sanding here, and it's okay there, more or less. I've got some sanding to do here. There really is no substitute for taking this cowling on and off 1,000 times in this process. Here is to kind of zip right along at this point, especially when you're sanding for a gap, to say good enough. And as I've written
on the RV Builders Hotline a number of times. I've been taught patience in this project so far. And just taking another couple of minutes to make it right kind of pays off. I'm no great builder, don't get me wrong, but I'm better than I was, and that's really my standard. Come take a look.
Well, this is the gap, which you probably can't even see. It's, let's see what we got here. About a 64th, which is not as wide as it's probably going to need to be for paint, but for now it's fine.
Here you can see the transition it's making with that top piece that I closed a gap on. It's really quite nice, and once I make a uniform gap all the way down later on, it'll be quite perfect.
Okay, so I found some hinge material here, so I'm going to go ahead and cut it. It's important to note that the instructions call for your pins to be changed from the aluminum they come with to the stainless steel. So I've had these hinges hanging around here now for a couple of years. I'm going to have to go figure out which ones go where at some point in terms of the pins.
Best part about cutting metal this time of the year is it keeps your hands warm. Okay, now all we gotta do is dimple, countersink, etc. So, I've got that in place.
Really, there were many reasons on this plane why I wouldn't park it in the RV corral at Oshkosh, but, you know, I don't think this Cowling is going to be one of them.
So, I've got it back on, and it's ready to go. I've already put the holes in the hinge, and so probably sometime this week, I'll probably do it in the evening when it's dark, I'll put a light in, see the holes, and drill it to it. And then I think I'll be able to get going on this cut right here, which will be the end of my nightmare, at least in terms of the heavy-duty stuff. So I'm feeling better about it. I think it's coming along pretty nice, and we'll see. Episode 4, you've noticed it's fleece season. Episode 4, I'll probably have the parka and the rabbit hat again. But for now, it's Sunday afternoon, it's fall, Minnesota, and I'm done working on the plane because I gotta go rake some leaves.